Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to get into the designer style. Now, designer is the artist who created Panda, a number one song. And, you know, the song came out before Kanye kind of put it on his TLOP album. But I didn't really pay attention to it before the album. I'm not sure why. But then when I heard it on Kanye's album, I didn't even know that was a song before. So I was like, oh, this is a song. So I went to go look up the real song. And that's what led me to Designer's Panda. And that was a while before it even began, you know, got all its buzz and et cetera, et cetera. But that was a good moment because it felt like you could feel it was a hit song. You just knew it was a hit song. And I was questioning, where are the hits in hip hop? Like, where are they at? So Designer is one of those artists who delivered a hit and you could feel it was a hit and you knew it was a hit. So we're not gonna, you know, clone the hit song Panda. We're gonna get into the elements so that you can build your own track and learn from the techniques of Panda. This is not a remake video. Anybody can copy notes and just put them into a piano roll. What we're gonna do is learn the technique so that you can apply it to become your own producer. So first, let's open up sounds. We need the right sounds in order to get the same vibe. So let's go to BusyWorksBeats.com. Let's load up the X drums. We're going to load up a kick, and we're going to load up a really heavy kick called Kick NK. Very big, and it's punchy. And as this loads, so there's the kick, and it has very similar sound to the one in the track. It could be the same exact sample, just processed a bit. So anyway, let's open up. We need a clap, but we're going to get into that later. So we need a snare, so let's load up snare and M. It's a specific bouncy snare. From the South, very common in Southern music. So we hear that in a lot of South records. Now the snare we're gonna pick is gonna be our own snare. I'm not gonna use the same exact snare they used in the track. So pick your own snare at this point. I'm gonna use snare CF in this case, which is a snare clap combo. And let's see what else we need. We need a hi-hat. Okay, so let's go to the hi-hats folder. Let's load up hi-hat X, very common hip-hop hi-hat. You hear it almost all the time. And where are we at here? So snare and M, we have kick and K, we have the hi-hat. We just need a clap. I'm going to get it from the Roland TR-808 kit, so I have a pure clap straight from the kit. And let's see what else we need. I'm trying to look at all the drum sounds, so forgive me. I have a list here, so I didn't forget. Okay, so now we need, an 808. Okay, so let's go into the 808s. And you can pick any 808 you want. What we're going to do with the 808 is play it in really low octaves, so we don't really hear the tone of the 808, we just feel it. So let's pick a nice one from the X kit. It comes with a couple 808s, so I'm going to use 808X. Now this 808 isn't super long, so hopefully that's long enough. Let's look for one that's a little bit longer. If this is too short, I'll replace it later, but it may or may not be too short depending on the notes we play. Okay, so now that we have the 808 and everything else, let's get into the instrument sound selection. Now, before we get into the instrument, sorry, let's go to the Roland TR-808. So I have that kit loaded up. And I'm going to look for the clap sample, which is somewhere around here. Should be two claps in here. I don't know where they are. Oh, cool. Here we go. So I'm going to use this clap here. So the Roland TR-808 kit is very common in hip hop. It's been used since however long ago, and it still is being used in top records. It just works. We're so used to these sounds. And let's see what else we can grab. I think that's it for the drums. Now let's get into instrument sound selection, which is a skill in itself. Again, not only do you need to know how to pick the right drums, you need to know how to pick the right instruments to get the same vibe and to understand the articulation or the playing styles of each instrument as well. So let's load up some tubular bells. Now I may or may not have tubular bells in my arsenal here. So let's load up the East West Library, which has a better chance of having tubular bells. Now tubular bells are found in East West libraries, like in Goliath, they have one, or in Nexus under their Dance Orchestra library, which I don't have on this system. But I do have the Hollywood expansion. Let me see if the Hollywood expansion in Nexus has some tubular bells. I'm not really sure. I haven't been looking for them lately. So let's just see if we can find some tubular bells. If not, I'll search the East West. But we're just looking for a church kind of bell. So let me right click and do a new search. Let's type in tubular. And it doesn't look like we have any luck. So let's type in bell. And let's see what our options are. Okay, in Nexus. And that's okay. It sounds a little dull to me as far as the transient. But that is the type of tone we're going for. Let's see what else we can find. Again, we're not looking for these kind of synth bells. We're looking for heavy, metallic FM style bells. And it looks like that's probably the only bell option that we can really grab. I'm not going to go through all of these. And you can hear that's a synth sound. You could also layer these bells. Pretty cool sound. So let me open up those bells and then let's clone this and let's open up the church bells. So we're kind of creating our own tone at this point. It's not going to be the same exact bells from the record. I'll look for tubular bells, but chances are I need Goliath, which I don't have active right now. So let's look through the Hollywood. I guess that would be percussion in this sound. Let's go to metals and let's see what we got here. I don't see tubular bells. Glockenspiel, finger bells, finger cymbals. Not sure what a crotales is, but it doesn't sound like a church bell. Oh, you know what? It might be under cymbals. Whoops. Probably not. So tubular bells are going to be what you need to hunt for. Let me see if I can find it in here. Doesn't look like we have that option. So again, I have found it in the Goliath sound library. So that's where you want to look. Now, the reason I grabbed East West is not for bell sounds. I grabbed it for an orchestra hit. So let's go to the strings and let's look for what's called a staccato or staccatissimo. We're looking for an ensemble staccatissimo. It's where it hits and then it dies out in sound. So let's go to full strings. Let's go to short. Whoops. And let's go to staccatissimo. Okay. And this is you're going to get used to all these Italian names. It just means short. It hits and then it dies out. Now, as that's loading up, let's look at the other sounds. We're going to build our own riser and layer our synth with the bell. So we already have that synth sound, which is the FM bell. So you can see how much work goes into finding the right sounds. If you don't take your time to find similar sounds, you're going to be just going off on a tangent. So I might switch these bells up. We'll figure it out. There's 100 bells here. Big bells. Okay, so let's see if East West is loaded up. And what else do we need? We have a riser, we have our orc hits, our drums, tubular bells, we have everything we need. So here's the staccatissimo sound. Not sure why it's not triggering here. Let me replace this. So as this loads, I'm going to pause the video so you don't have to wait. So I swapped out the East West with Contact 5's, Session Strings Pro. And I went to Articulations, changed this to Short Notes, and then went to Staccato. Because the other library had a different timbre. It was a really low pitch staccato, and that's not what I'm looking for. So anyway, that's the only change I made in sound selection. So now we can play chords as a hit. But again, you want to look for orchestral hits. They come in different libraries. And I think there's even, let me open up Contact. I think in the actual Contact library, if you change the articulation or the playing style, let's see. Let's go back to the main folder. So if you go to orchestral, go to strings, and then go to string ensemble, you can change the way you play. Okay, you could do the same thing here. Change it from, you know, sustain to staccato for more of an impact sound. So you really want to experiment with the impact sounds because that's where that orchestral hit sound comes from. All right, so I'm not going to spend too much time trying to dig into the exact sound. Okay, we're going to use both of those. Here, one's a little bit longer than the other. Okay, so you can see how much work goes into sound selection. This is not something menial. This is a skill to find the right sounds. Okay, so we have all the orchestral sounds, we have the tubular sounds, we have the drums. Now we need to build our own riser that goes, you know. So let's open up Silenth 1. We're going to build a makeshift sound. I'm not going to get into sound design and everything about it. So you can follow along. I'm just going to turn it on a sawtooth wave. We're going to give it a pitch envelope, so it goes up in pitch. So let's tell the envelope 1 to control pitch A. Give it its max value for the pitch and give it an attack time. And that's how you create that sound. Now you can put reverb and delay on it inside, but I'm going to use reverb and delay in the mixer instead because we have a lot more control. So I'm going to open up a Fruity Reverb 2, close out the browser here, open up the reverb. Okay, so we can add our own reverb tail to it. Okay, so that's all we're going to do. Now you can lower the pitch amount because that might be too much pitch bending. So I lowered it just a bit because it sounded a little too playful. It was moving too fast. So that's all we're going to do there. So that's the sound effects. So now we have all the sounds. So I know that took some time, but again, that is a skill. So let's start with the chords. We're going to go ding, 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 ding. Okay, so we're going to use Meek Mill techniques for the chords, similar to how in our Jahlil Beats tutorial. So it's the same kind of sound here. So let's go to let's go to Nexus. Let's start with the bells. And let's start with our pseudo leading tone first before we try to build out chords. Let's just do one note at a time. So let's just add these in. And again, you want to have the right articulation. So if I just did short notes, it doesn't give me the same vibe. You want to make sure these notes are dragged out all the way, so they're full notes. And I'm going to change the velocity here to see if we can get a different sound. So I'm going to create my own pattern. I'm not going to copy what they did. So we're going to go from B to G. So it's in three. So B, 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 G, 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 B, B. That sounds like we're going a little too fast. But that's because the actual shape of the sound. So what we need to do, I'm not going to reshape it, but what you want to look into is release time. And turn down your sustain, because sustain makes it feel like, you know, it makes it feel very plasticky and fake. So now what we can do is either go with a chord, which is probably not the ideal sound. So we're going to go with octave. And I'm going to go with an octave higher. Actually, that sounds too overly done. So let's just keep it how it is. Copy that and paste it into our synth bells. Now these bells don't sound the same. I'm going to load up bells that match the vibe better. These sound a little bit better. And I'm going to lower the volume just below the church bells. Now for these synth bells, okay, what I want to do is create an octave, because this is more open to octave. Whereas the kind of organic sound doesn't necessarily sound good with an octave. This sound, I'm going to EQ out some of that low end. It's a little heavy. Add a high pass filter with an EQ too. So we still get the tone, but we don't get the weight of the bass. I'm going to pull that down in the mix. And I'm going to pan this right to balance out the sound. So we have this pan kind of left, and we're going to pan our synths to the right to balance out that energy. A very simple pattern. Let's add that into the playlist. Now in his song, he has a lot of cuts and mutes. We're not going to get into all the mutes and cuts. That's what you do after you record for dramatic emphasis. You know, that's a post-production type of thing. You could do it in the beat, but again, you're forcing the artist to do something with that mute. Mutes are usually created after an artist is recording or after they have their lyrics. So now we're going to start with the hi-hat to kind of build the rhythm. It's just going to be very basic. We're just going to right-click, fill each two steps for the hi-hat. So it's basically eighth notes. Actually, I think that's too fast. Let's go with eighth notes. Now let's go with our kick and snare. Notice we didn't really introduce music yet. Now the snare is going to go on the 3 and the 7 rather than the 2 and the 4. Okay, now keep in mind we're using a different key, so it's not going to sound like Panda because we're not musically the same. So, I got bras and a lemon. Listen to the theme of Panda. Now I'm going to add my own flair, which is a back-to-back kick here, just for a little more energy. Now what we need to do is shape the church bells, because they're starting to take over the sound. Either turn them down or reshape the transient, or the body of the sound. I'm just going to turn them down. Turn that hi-hat down. Now in Panda, the drums, the kick, and the snare are really like the loudest parts. Everything else is really quiet. Now I'm going to do the kind of the clap fill. So it's right click, fill each 4 steps. I'm going to do that and I'm going to get rid of the drum. Okay, so that's what I'm doing, but let's do it over here somewhere so it kind of makes sense musically. Into the orc hits, and let's add that sound effect. Now we're only going to play it for a certain amount of time, and I'm going to start at the note B just because it's the right pitch. Okay, so we need to drag it out for the proper amount of time. So it needs a little more delay, so it has a longer tail. So let's add Fruity Delay 2. Let's go ping pong mode. Give it a nice feedback tail. Now you can delay the delay. You can right click and create an automation clip and, you know, make the delay come in a little bit later. So what we can do is create an on off switch basically, so the delay doesn't pick up on the beginning part of the sound. So I'm going to let it fade in rather than just come in strong like that. So let's just do something like this. Turn down that feedback and input a bit. So now let me slice this out. So it's just for this area. Let's get rid of the excess. And I think theirs was a lower pitch. Let me hit control down. And it might have gone up faster. So let me I think that's how theirs was. Yeah, there we go. A nice low pitch. There we go. So what I'm doing is changing the speed of the pitch bend with this knob here. I don't want that that high pitch. Okay, so that's a nice cutoff. So let's add a little more emphasis. Boom. So let's add that B note in a very low octave. This is for the orc hit. And musically, we want to make sure we're, you know, in sync with the bells. So again, that first note was B. So I'm using B as the note that we're going to use for the orchestral hit as well. Now that was the wrong pattern. So let's go to pattern 6, add that in. You can hear it's kind of quiet. So let's crank up the volumes. And also I'm going to add octaves. So let's pull this down an octave. Okay, and let's do octaves. So let's hit control up, so we have two octaves. A nice impact. You can hear the bell's a little detuned from this sound. That's because the bell is created with a different It's created with different synthesis. Okay, so when you add real sounds, it could sound detuned because it's used. For example, church bells and all these bells might be FM synth, and that gives you a different timbre. It's not as, it might not match perfectly. But anyway, so the note is B, so we know that's the musical note. Let's paste that in to each of these staccatos. I'm just gonna add these in. I think theirs lasted a little bit longer. So let me change, let me work on that pitch bend a little bit more. I think that's how long theirs lasted. Let me just pull the pitch down a bit. So now all we need is the 808, and the 808 is pretty simple. We're going to use constant notes and then 808 slides going down and up. So it's very easy once you figure it out, or once you know how to do it, I should say. Let's right click. Let's go to edit for the 808. Before we plug in notes for the 808, you need to tune, because musically, when you're making edits, you can be super incorrect, you know, when it comes to trying to apply music theory. So you need to tune your 808 to understand what you're doing musically. Let's go to the marker tab. Let's go to detect pitch regions. This 808's in the key of A. So let's go to the envelope tab and let's right click on the note A to tune this 808 to A. We have a whole video on tuning and how to do that with 808. So just type in tuning BusyWorks beats into Google or YouTube and you'll find the video. We also have a video called 808 slides and glides. So if you get lost in these techniques, just go search those terms and you'll find the longer videos. For slides, we need to activate what's called portamento in our 808, and I'm also going to activate what's called monophonic mode. So when I overlap notes, it only plays one note at a time rather than two notes. So now we're going to start with the note B. Again, I like to program my 808s in a higher octave before I get to, you know, because I want to hear the tone. So let's go into a higher octave. So the 808 is going to be nice and short. It's almost going to sound like a bell tone. But we're going to lower that octave later. I just need to hear the actual pitch of the 808. So when we drop it down into the octaves, I can hear it. Because when you get into low octaves, it's very hard to hear the tone. So it's very basic. Boom, 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 boom. Here I want an 808 slide. So what I'll do here, you don't even need to have FL Studio to do slides. What you need to do is have portamento activated like we just went over, and I'm going to use an octave. So it's, you know, the 808's up here and then it's going to drop down an octave, and portamento will make this pitch bend. Now in the 808, if you want it to be more of an evident pitch bend, right now it's just pretty quick. You turn up the slide parameter. You hear it go wing wing wing. That's how you make your slides more apparent. But I want mine to be a little more fluid, so I'm going to make this a slide note, which just means you could do the same thing in any other DAW. It's like moving your pitch wheel down. That's what we're doing here. Not sure why it's silenced, so let me see what's going on. Oh, you know what, the 808 died out, so let's hit control down. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is copy what we just made, and at the end here I'm going to go down and then back up again, so we have a down slide, and then for here I'm going to go up an octave. Actually, you know what? Let's go down, up, right, you know, back to back. So let's do that one more time. I'm going to slide this over. So it goes down, and then one's going to go up. So we're creating our own 808 slides here. Okay, so now let's drop these into the low bass ranges. So I'm going to hit control down. Insert this into the song. Let's crank up the church bell a little bit more. It needs a little more aggressive aggression. It needs a little more of that. So I'm going to add exciters to the bell to up the harmonic activity of the bell. Because it sounds like ding, ding, it sounds very weak. So let's open up Isotope's Exciter. You could do this with any harmonic exciter. I'm just gonna pull up these bands. You can hear it adds that sizzle. The tube's a little more exaggerated, but we need that aggression in the tone. So let's hear that. Insert a snare roll. So I left that for last because it's optional. But for the snare, I'm going to go to pattern. Where are we at? Pattern 3. Let's make this unique at the end. So every 4 bars or so, I'm going to change these to pattern 4. Select source pattern. Let's go to pattern 4. Now here we're going to create a snare roll. So I'm going to insert more of these snares. So I'm going to go to piano roll. I'm going to highlight those last 2 notes, drag them out. It's going to snap to grid, quarter steps, and I'm going to hit control U. That's going to create a glitch section. So it gives you that glitch sound. So we go over snare rolls and hi-hat rolls. Just type that into YouTube or Google, BusyWorks Beats, and you'll find, you know, hi-hat rolls, snare rolls, BusyWorks Beats. You'll find the video going in depth about that. next step is to record in the mind of the artist, which would be designer in this case. Now, he raps super fast, so I'm not sure if I can really give you the best lyric, but what we might do is just kind of do the gibberish technique where you go through, not necessarily with words, but you go through and kind of add the tone, because sound and language starts with a, you know, tone. It starts with cadence and tone. So what you want to do is kind of gibber, you know, use gibberish to kind of get your way through. And that will give you a better, you know, way to perceive your song, where to add mutes, where the energy needs to increase, where it needs to decrease. Okay, that's a technique you want to use after all your tracks. Figure out who are you building the track for and where can they fit in the track. And you'll start to see the flaws that you have in your production. So that is the next step. So if I have enough time, I'll record in the mind of the designer. If you want these project files, you can get these for free if you go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. And sign up with your email. Okay, be sure to confirm your email to open up the download page. Okay, so you can click that link below to get started to get these free project files. Thanks for watching. It's busyworksbeats.com.